Have you ever found yourself watching a movie with people around you who don't understand the language that is being spoken? Or perhaps you're trying to watch something yourself, but the language is foreign. I've personally found myself in the first scenario more times than I thought I would. The most obvious solution would be to enable subtitles in a language that we understand. But oftentimes, the movies that we watch don't come with subtitles in foreign languages. So that's what this video is about. In this video, I will show you how to get custom subtitles on almost any website, as well as how to translate any .srt subtitles that you already have. Starting off with YouTube. YouTube is the easiest one. Most other websites will require plugins to do this sort of stuff. But when it comes to translating subtitles, it doesn't get any easier than YouTube. So if you didn't already know, you can rent or purchase titles on YouTube. One way to go about doing this is by going to youtube.com/movies. However, I personally like to buy my movies from Google Play Movies because they also work with YouTube, and it's just a better experience over there. Before you make your purchase, just make sure that your movie has subtitles so that this will work. Once you have your movie, go to your purchases page on YouTube on the left side. Then find your movie and play it. There is a cogwheel on the bottom right of the video. Click on it, then go to subtitles, and then enable the native option first. Then go back to the cogwheel, go back to subtitles, this time go to auto translate. There are like a bajillion options here, so take your time and find your option. So the auto translated subtitles are actually fed through Google Translate. So they're not perfect, they're machine translated, but they're almost there. The second method I will be demonstrating in this video is how to translate or insert your own custom subtitles into Netflix movies. This one is pretty easy actually, but it requires a little bit more work. To insert custom subtitles into Netflix movies, you need a plugin called Super Netflix. If you are currently using the Google Chrome browser, this can be downloaded very easily. Go to the Google Chrome web store and search for Super Netflix. And from here, it's as simple as installing an app. To get your subtitles, you need to go to a website called Subflix. Even if you already have your own .srt subtitle files, Super Netflix can only read .dfxp files. So Subflix will allow you to convert your .srt files into .dfxp files. Additionally, Subflix hosts subtitles for various movies in a variety of languages. Just scroll down, you can use the search bar if need be, and look for your desired subtitles and download them. Once you have your file, head over to Netflix.com. Browse to the corresponding movie, and now in the top right corner you should see a button that looks like a speech bubble. Click on it, browse to your file, and now in the speech bubble on the bottom, you should be able to see your custom subtitles. The last method I will be showing in this video should work for nearly all content on the web that is played in video form. It is a little more complicated though, and currently it is infinitely more finicky. I would only really recommend this option if you're an advanced user. Even then, it still takes quite some time to figure out. So back on the Google Chrome Web Store, there are a number of plugins that enable subtitles for HTML5 videos. Now, I can't personally recommend any of these because my experience with all of them haven't been very smooth. This was a while ago, but I just didn't find them very reliable at all. Generally, downloading one of these plugins will give you a button in the top right corner where your toolbar is, and you would use that to insert custom subtitles in your videos. Now, to my knowledge, all of these plugins use .srt subtitle files, so you won't have to do any conversions with Subflix. Now I'm going to go over where you can get custom .srt subtitle files. This is beneficial for pretty much the last two of the three methods that I've mentioned earlier. Personally, my favorite website to get subtitle files from is YIFY Subtitles. They have a pretty good user experience, but if you can't find what you're looking for here, you can go to opensubtitles.org. Now, don't worry if you can't find a subtitle file for your desired language. Just download the best one for now. I would usually go for the English one. Then, go to translate.google.com/toolkit. You will need a Google account for this. Don't worry, this is a Google service. Once you're signed in, go to Tools on the left side, and then Translation Memories. Then hit Upload on the left. From here, create a translation memory called blank and add TM. This file does not have to be shared as it will remain blank. This step only has to be done once, so if you plan on translating more subtitles in the future, you won't have to do this again. Once you're done, go back to Active under Translations, hit Upload, upload your subtitle file, and then choose your starting language. In my case, I downloaded my subtitle in English, so I will start off with that. Then below, choose the language that you would like to have your file translated into. Click Tools to expand, and make sure your translation memory is set to blank. You can also leave glossary as none. The next page will offer premium translations. Click No Thanks on the bottom left, unless you want to pay a few hundred dollars for a translated subtitle file. Now click on the subtitle file that you just uploaded. On the left side is the original text, but on the right side is the machine translated text. That's right, Google just automatically machine translated your entire subtitle file, at no charge. Now again, since this is being put through Google Translate, it is not going to be perfect, but it's good enough. Now to retrieve your translated subtitles, go to File on the top left and click on Download. And there you have it. Now you know how to translate subtitle files and use them on practically any website on the internet. That's it for this video. I hope you learned something new, and I will see you in the next one. Thanks for watching. Just wanted to show you that I'm not actually watching anything here.